Michael just had this chronic inability to sleep. I mean, I knew, having worked in the media for years, that he had a difficulty with it. I had no idea of how bad it was. I mean, he would literally be unable to get any sleep at all, right? Night after night.
Well, just coming off the stage, and there's like 180,000 people out there, and your adrenaline is going so high, and you're doing so much, and it's hard to just put your head on the pillow and sleep, because it just goes on and on, even after you're off the stage. He always said that he didn't want to tour because he didn't want to have the problems of not sleeping and having to take Demerol and things like that, but he wasn't addicted to it because his behavior wasn't to the point that he was an addict. He was looking for this for sleep, and he trusted whoever administered these things to him. He trusted them.
I mean, when people hear about drug addictions, like with celebrities, they tend to think, you know, cocaine or ecstasy or heroin, whatever it may be. Clearly, we're not in that kind of situation with Michael. These were not drugs to make him high or get any kind of high experience. The drugs he was taking were all for pain and all for sleep.
Exactly.
Could it have been, though, that by the end, after years of insomnia, that he had become, in a way, addicted to any type of drug that would get him the sleep he craved? Do you think that's possible?
I really don't know, but I do know that it's a difference between Demerol and propofol.
Tell me about propofol, because you've studied this for your book, and it's fascinating what you found out. It's a much stronger drug than people realize.
It's a much stronger drug. It puts you out, and it's basically used when people are under the knife and they want to not feel the pain. But the key to this is when you're a proven anesthesiologist, and you're in the proper settings, in the right medical field, you know how much to administer into the patient to keep him above the line, but not so above where he'll feel the pain, and keep them from going below the line.
Propofol considered by most physicians to be an anesthetic rather than just a sleeping pill?
I really don't know, but I do know for Michael to get sleep, he had to be knocked out. And this wasn't just this one night. This was administered in him on an ongoing basis, which was causing his body to deteriorate and him to act different and have different symptoms in his behavior.
You as a family, you were probably the closest to Michael of all the family. But collectively, you must have all known that he had this ongoing chronic problem with sleep in particular. When you saw Conrad Murray come on the scene and stuff, did you get to know him well? Did you try and work out what he was prescribing? Were you concerned enough to do that?
To answer your question, Pierce, the first time I saw Conrad Murray was in the hospital when my brother was dead. The first time I saw him.
You never spoken to him? You never met him?
Never spoken to him ever. I understand that there was something with Paris that he came into their lives before, but the first time I saw him was in the hospital, and I just didn't have a good feeling.